According to the Auditor General's report, out of the 78.1 billion recoverable funds that were expected to be recovered from beneficiaries of the Youth Livelihood Programme in 2021 and 2022 financial year by the Minister of Gender, only 39 billion shillings was recovered, representing a 50% recovery rate. The low recovery rate attracted concerns from members of parliament wondering how the project can succeed if dispersed funds are not recovered.
If in whole financial year I've recovered 1 billion out of the 39 outstanding billion, when will you recover this 39 billion?
The youth know themselves. Does the ministry involve the National Youth Council in youth affairs? Are they anywhere here?
We want to see whether it is tenable to continue with these recoveries, since now the interest has moved to PDM, to Emioga, and they seem to be no concern on this. So unpack these receivables for us.
The Permanent Secretary in the Ministry of Gender, Labour and Social Development, Agre David Chibenge, told the committee that most youth groups fell apart due to the lack of cohesion, which made it difficult for the ministry to track them down. COVID-19 pandemic has also been blamed for low recovery rates of the Youth Livelihood Programme funds.
Some of these youth groups disintegrated, I think as a result of lack of cohesion at that level, and youth by their nature, understandably, some shared out the money within the group and said, for us, we want to do something else. So tracking these groups and the beneficiaries has been a bit of a problem, both for the center and at the district local government level.
Similar challenges are associated with the Uganda Women's Enterprise Program. Legislators are concerned that failure to recover outstanding amounts of money in a timely manner hinders access of funds by other groups.
I'd like to know who are those defaulters that are taking this money as money to eat. Because, you know, some of our citizens think that the money was donated to them. They don't know that it is a revolving fund which needs to support others.
The district should be charged to recover the money. And the beneficiaries should also have security. So you must show security that you will have capacity to pay back.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, much of these monies which are there, Emioga, this one, the youth, they have their own challenges because at the district level, they turn it into politics. And then the ministry is responsible, have a big challenge.
The Minister of Gender says they have written fresh circulars to local governments, reminding them to step up their recovery of funds and remit them back to the Bank of Uganda.
The only challenge we had was YLP. When we get to YLP, you'll see that the performance of WEP in terms of recovery was much better. So until we received resources now in the last financial year where they joined the WEP and YLP in terms of management, that's when we are now able to again support even recovery of YLP.
The audit report also highlighted issues of non-transfer of recovered funds to the recovery account amounting to 7.2 billion shillings under UWEP. Yet some funds amounting to 1.8 billion shillings were remitted to the national recovery account without tagging it to particular districts. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.